rainy weather welcomes you to Portland, Oregon today, but it won't put a damper on our spirits as it's the opening day of the college basketball season, and we open up with the Willamette Bearcats and the Portland Pilots. Welcome inside the Child Center. I'm Brian Zeich, joined by former Gonzaga Bulldog Jennifer Mountain, and we're delighted to have you join us for opening night. Now, there is a lot of praise for the Pilots coming into this season due to their preseason poll rankings, and the Bearcats, they like to play a little feisty style of play. So what can we expect tonight, Jennifer?
Well, like you said, opening night, this is what they've been waiting for the last few weeks, beating up on each other in practice. Now it's time to go against somebody else, a true opponent. It's a great opportunity for both squads going into the season, a little tune-up here. And I like Willamette's opportunities to score the basketball. They're real feisty, like you said. They get out and go in the open court. And the Pilots, ranked number 2 in the WCC in the preseason poll, have a lot to prove.
Well, one of the players that the Bearcats are going to rely on heavily tonight is their junior guard, Megan River.
Yeah, big impact point guard right now for them. And it's really going to be crucial for her to handle pressure, control tempo tonight, and make sure that they take care of the ball and limit turnovers. They don't want to go into Portland style as far as getting out in that open court. She's got to do a good job of just taking control of everything going on the offensive end.
Well, Portland doesn't make things easy, but Willamette has shocked the Pilots in the past. How do they do it again?
Well, like I said, got to handle the full court pressure that Portland's going to apply. And then in the half court, they have to get some ball movement, get quality execution. They have to execute with ball movement, good, shoot really well from the three-point line, minimize easy opportunities for Portland tonight. That's going to be a huge one. And then they are undersized, no matter what we talk about. They're going to be playing 5 guards in all spots, so they've got to rebound.
Well, Portland, they're still without their all-conference guard in Haley Andrews, but Coach Meek has the confidence in our player to watch, Kelsey Lindsay, to lead this bunch.
Yeah, he really likes her leadership where she's at right now. She's taking that leadership role over from Haley. She started off the season with high expectations, and Portland, you know, coaches really, really like what they see so far. She's got to do a good job of, again, controlling tempo, getting great half-court opportunities, and breaking down that defense.
Well, the Pilots, they love defending home court. What do they need to do to walk away with a victory today?
Well, their style is pressure, pressure, pressure for 40 minutes, so they have got to do that without getting themselves in early foul trouble. Big one. Limiting turnovers, that's kind of been something the Achilles heel in the past. Make sure they take care and share the basketball. And then last but not least, they got to rebound the ball.
All right, well, the opening of the 2022-2023 basketball season is just about here. Starters and Tip when we return on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center for opening night basketball here in Portland, Oregon, between the Portland Pilots and the Willamette Bearcats. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with the call. Let's get you the starters for today's lineup for both sides. So let's start with the Willamette Bearcats in the starting lineup for them. It's going to be the guard Sammy Riggs, along with our player to watch, Megan River, Carolyn Ho, Claire Bonet, and then Ashlyn Esquena-Mercil, the senior forward, will get the start as well. For the Portland Pilots, it's going to be Maisie Burnham, Kelsey Lindsay, our player to watch, Keely Frawley, Alex Fowler, and Liana Kai-Tu'u. So a lot of familiar faces for the Portland Pilots tonight, Jennifer.
Yeah, and you're going to see so many different lineups, you know, running through tonight. You're going to get different mixes of people on both squads, to be honest with you. And just the way Portland plays, they're going to put so much pressure. You're going to see a lot of subs in and out. And, you know, really excited about this group. Like we talked about in the open, preseason pick number 2 in the West Coast Conference. And, you know, talking with Coach Pegg, you know, she has high expectations from this really young group that she has. Even their seniors with the COVID issues only have played 2 seasons. So this is going to be a good game for both squads just to kind of see where they're at and you know, test the waters a little bit.
And there's a look at Peg Swatner right there in her 11th year as the head coach of the Bearcats. Helped the team to a 12-13 overall record last season in Northwest Conference play. On the other side for the Portland Pilots, it's the fourth year man, Michael Meek, who has a 55-35 overall record at UP, but has an 800 winning percentage overall in his 15 years as the head coach.
He's done a tremendous job everywhere he's been, so.
Willamette wins the opening tip. They're in white with Willamette in maroon across the chest. Portland in their black uniforms. Portland in white, and the first bucket goes down for Ho.
And that's one of the keys, is getting quality shots in the half court and getting ball movement. And that's going to be a big factor the rest of this ball game.
Lindsay looking for Fowler on the block. She gets double teamed, kicks it out to Frawley in the corner. Whips out, rebound by Fowler, and the putback is good.
Well, that's where Willamette's going to really struggle, I think, this evening, is just with the size and difference. And the rebounding is going to be a huge key, just an easy putback there for Fowler.
And Fowler, fifth all-time in program history at the Division I level for Portland. And after that rebound, just 52 away from breaking the all-time record.
Well, she's just so darn versatile. I mean, she can do it all and has expanded that, you know, her game a little bit, that three-point range we saw a little bit at the end of the season last year, and something that she's worked on even further.
Kaitu'u gets it into Burnham on the block. Bullies the defender, and it goes.
And that's what Maisie's really good at, just doing her, doing a job down low. She's getting, you know, got that height advantage at the guard spot and just really strong.
Esquenya Mercil puts up the three off the glass, no good. Rebound by Frawley.
Not a bad shot, just got to get some second opportunities by crashing the boards a little bit.
Frawley looking for Kaitu'u. Fowler will give it to her, and another way up for Portland.
Well, and you can just see right now, and that's their game plan, just that high-low option with multiple people. Just the size difference is going to be a little bit tough for Willamette to deal with, I think, throughout the evening.
Frawley cuts off River, and it causes a travel and a turnover. I have a feeling with this defense, we're going to be calling out a lot of turnovers today.
You know, it's really hard to prepare against a team like Portland because of the style that they play. You can't simulate it in practice. They're bringing pressure every single second, so you just do not get into a normal rhythm. And especially so easy, early in the season, it's really tough for opponents.
Lindsay can't hit the floater while attacking the basket. Bearcats get it inside, and Ho hits her second basket of the night.
That's good composure right there. She kind of was a little bit off balance when she caught it, but you know, just stayed true to what she was trying to do, saw things, and took the open shot herself. Nice little mid-range jumper.
Pass inside, triple team, kicked it out to Burnham near the wing for the three, it goes! First triple of the season.
Smart touch pass by Alex inside, and you know, you look at this group, there's pretty much everybody on the floor can shoot the three right now, and that's a nice weapon to have.
Pilots applying the pressure in half court. Full court, I should say, excuse me. River almost moved her foot, and she misses from the elbow. Burnham with it, top. Gets the pass inside to Kaitu'u underneath the basket, and there she'll finish it off.
I like to see that from her early in the game. Mm-hmm. We've talked about, you know, her strength inside. Sometimes she, I think, preferred in the past just to kind of play that mid-range perimeter. They're going to need her to bang down low, and that's a nice sign for the Pilots. Good ball movement by the Bearcats.
Moving it around. Ho fakes a three, got Burnham to jump. Now she takes it to the hoop and can't hit. Rebound by Portland. Pilots pushing it up. Fowler running down the court. Saves it from going out of bounds. Burnham spins, turn, off the glass, and good.
I'll tell you, you know, when she was at Eastern, Big Sky Freshman of the Year, we saw her develop last year, and now she knows this system. One of the best mid-range games I've seen.
As Esquenya Mercil gets the layup.
Good job by Willamette of breaking that full court pressure and getting a nice opportunity down low.
Well, I remember talking to you about Maisie Burnham last year and just coming from Spangle, Washington, such a small town and the community for basketball. And her growth, like you just said, has come such a long way as Fowler makes the basket underneath.
Yeah, and anytime you transfer into a program, especially one that runs a certain system. You got to get used to it, find your role. And I think she did a nice job as of, especially the end of that season, last half of the season. Push off right there. Yeah. Good call. Riggs just extended her arm there. Offensive foul, easy call from the official.
All right, almost a fresh five, but four will come in. Straylene, Meek, MJ Bruno, and Emmy Shearer will come in. So Fowler's the lone starter that stays on the court.
Well, and I think we're going to talk about this a lot, the depth that Portland has. I mean, we just sub four. We could have sub five, and he's got another three on the bench that will play minutes. So, and they're healthy. I mean, that's how you, every program in the country, you know, you stay healthy, you got great chance, and he's got a lot of weapons on that bench.
Well, when we talked to Meek earlier this week, he talked about, or I should say last week since it's Monday, he talked about some of the injuries at the start of last season, and it was hard to get a rotation going because of the lack of depth, so it's nice to have healthy bodies to start the season.
Oh, for sure. I mean, that's a treat for any coach, and he's got, it's not that he just has depth, he has quality depth.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of these players would be starting for other schools, other teams, and I think they just complement each other so well, and they've bought into the system, and that's a huge factor.
And you can tell they bought into 14 returners from 17 players last year. Yep. Two of them graduated. Good ball movement from the Bearcats and a foul underneath. We'll see who they call it on.
Well, they're doing a better job in the front court here of just not forcing the issue and putting it on the ground. All of a sudden making a couple passes and they have opportunities in the half court. Much better job of just making that adjustment by the Bearcats.
Well, after the foul, that sends us to the media break. 17-6, an 11-point lead for the Pilots. They've made their last five baskets. We'll be right back with more opening night basketball. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Just under 5 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Willamette and Portland in this one. Jen, we talked about it briefly in the open, but Portland, they were picked preseason number two in the conference. That's the highest they've been since the mid-90s in a preseason poll for the WCC.
And I think well-deserved. You know, it's a coach's poll. It's voted on by all the teams in the conference. And you know, I'm really excited about the conference this year. You know, GU is picked number one, Portland number two, BYU three, and then you have USF, Santa Clara, St. Mary's, San Diego, all quality teams from last year. And quite frankly, I mean, from top to bottom, this conference, you can win any night if you play well. So, you know, I think it was well-deserved, and I'm really anticipating if they stay healthy, they got a great run at it.
Yeah, especially with how they've played the last few years. Now, you know, last season, unfortunately, near the end of the year, you lost Haley Andrews, and so that played a factor in some of those tight games at the end. But with this health, I mean, this team can really do some damage in the non-conference against some tough opponents, whether they win or not, but they'll make it tough on them.
Well, that's where that depth comes in, like we're talking about, and they're going to get Andrews back at some point, and that just accentuates everything they're doing. And she's such a great leader, even being off, you know, the floor right now. She's doing some things as far as coaching people up and talking people through things, and just a great asset, whether she's on or off the floor.
Yeah, Coach Meek talked about how important that's been for the team and her involvement, staying involved even while being injured. And like you just said, another coach basically on that bench.
Well, when you're injured, you see things a lot differently. And especially when it's, you know, an injury like that, where it's an ACL or, you know, an injury where you're off for months, you get a different perspective. And she's one that already kind of has that coach's mind. Mm-hmm. And I would not be surprised seeing her on a sideline at some point.
Yeah. Fowler made that last basket. She now has 8 points. Portland's on a 13-2 run currently. River almost lost it. Gives it up to Caitlin Imai. Ho with a mid-range shot. It falls. She's got 6 points, and she leads all Bearcats.
Again, they're doing such a better job in the beginning against this press, getting themselves into the half court. They've had success. I mean, they're shooting 50% from the floor when they're getting attempts. So just that slowing the pace down a little bit has been very, very helpful for them.
Ho averaged 8.6 points per game last season. And they called a travel on Fowler?
I think 3 seconds. I was kind of blocked out, but yeah. Going back to Ho, she was a soccer player before even turned into basketball. Hasn't played basketball her whole life, so coach was really excited about her and just her athleticism. You can see she's got a little bit of length.
Mm-hmm. Talk about endurance too. Having, you know, soccer, you got to have that endurance and going up and down the court. It sort of plays into how Portland plays defense.
Soccer players have great footwork.
Yep.
Best shooters I've ever had were soccer players.
Because they squared up to the basket, had
just
good
footwork. Their footwork, just getting shots off so much faster.
Passes almost taken away by Emma Straline. And it goes out of bounds. It will be Willamette basketball.
Glad to see Emmy Shear at full strength. You know, she kind of fought injuries off and on last mm-hmm. year, and she's just so athletic and long and can play in so many different spots. That's the one thing, is the versatility, not just depth, versatility in and out.
And she stepped up in such a big way, too, because when Haley went out last year, they were trying to find that second, third scorer, and it rotated around a little bit. It seemed like Shearer took it for a couple weeks, and then it became Burnham that stepped up, and then Rose Pflug at the end of the season played a huge factor for the Pilots. Straline is blocked, and it's kept alive by Frawley.
There's that out of bounds. I'll tell you, they're one of the best in the country at out of bounds plays.
And a travel called on Lindsay. She wanted to shoot.
Yeah, I think she kind of lost the handle a little bit there. I didn't see the feet move, but nonetheless.
Yep. Ho with it in the backcourt. Pressure put on by Lindsay. Picks up the dribble. And a turnover.
You know, before the first timeout, they only had 2 turnovers. 2 quick ones here after that timeout. Got to do a better job in that front court.
Shear trying to use the glass too strong. Peyton Gardner through the lane, but can't connect.
Mm.
And they're going to call travel on Kelsey Lindsay.
Yeah, good job by Ho, just kind of anticipating that. Didn't really let her land. But you got to see that if you're passing to a teammate right there, just giving her a little bit of space to be able to catch and land.
Straline will go to the bench along with Shearer. Looks like Burnham now comes back out on the court, along with Fowler after the breather. River takes the inbound pass. Double teamed by Portland. Has an open Collins underneath in the finish with the left hand.
Great vision by River. Just doing a nice job over the top. Got double teamed and wide open underneath the basket.
Lindsay gets it to Kaitu, who spin around Collins in the finish with the left hand.
You can see there, again, game plan. Just go post somebody up on the block, whether it's a guard or a post.
Well, Portland has the size advantage, and looking at the bench right now for Willamette, they're without their second-team all-conference player, Ava Kitchen, right now, who hasn't made an appearance, and Collins can't handle the pass. It goes out of bounds and a turnover by the Bearcats.
Again, talking with Coach Pegg, you know, this last week, and She really likes this young group, how they've, you know, really the leadership, the chemistry so far. These are the types of games you learn a lot about your squad. And so far, I mean, you can see the fight in them, that's for sure. They're real scrappy, playing hard, and they're going to learn a lot from this.
Bonet with it. Over to Ho. Gets it near the elbow. Over to Riggs. Mid-range jumper on the baseline is long.
Decent look.
And Willamette's had some good looks, just nothing has fallen right now here in the first quarter. Over to Lindsay in the corner. Hits the triple.
And Coach Meek's going to be happy to see a couple threes going down early. They struggled from the three-point line at times last year with such a great shooting team, you know. We talked about it, but that right there is where Lindsay's really good. I mean, I know she's playing the point guard spot right now with Haley out, but she's really an off guard, so that's nice to see her get some attempts from that three-point line and get some rhythm going.
We talked to Coach Meek so many times last season. He's like, if we could just hit these threes, I already know we're dangerous, but we'll be that much more. And, you know, just never had the consistency. So, like you said, you're happy to see these early buckets fall.
Well,
Bruno checks in.
The ability's there. They just, for whatever reason, you can say luck, whatever, but he's got some kids that can really stroke it.
River from three. That one goes for the Bearcats.
Good answer right there by River.
Shot clock is off.
9-point game right now. You know, they're hanging in.
It's 5 seconds on the clock. Fowler will put up a three from dead ahead. Back iron, no good. River can't bring it in. Rebound by Burnham, and the clock runs out. So Portland takes an 11-point lead into the second quarter. 24-13. As we head to the second quarter, we'll be back with more action on the WCC Network. Well, there's a look at Haley Andrews. She's dealing with a leg injury that she suffered last year against BYU. She's actually the only Division I player returning with at least 1,400 points, 450 rebounds, 500 assists, and 100 steals. She's just one of the most productive players in Pilots history.
She's a special player, and I mean, we've had such great conversations with her in the last couple years, and I'm so excited for her to get back. I'm sure Coach Meek is as well, but you know, she's got a little bit more time to get healed and certainly don't want to come back too fast, but she's going to be in a great position once end of November, beginning of December.
Yeah,
we'll see what happens. Just a little too much dribbling right there by River. She's got to get it out of her hands quicker.
Yeah, she's fortunate she got the foul called on Fowler. That'll be her second personal foul and the team's first of this quarter. Meek will come in for Lindsay. Frawley comes in for Fowler.
I tell you, Keely Frawley, I mean, that's a kid that you don't see a lot scoring the ball, but I'll tell you, stat sheet-wise, she does all the little things. She's got 2 assists, 2 rebounds so far. Just plays extremely hard, deflections, just makes things happen, and a big key for these guys, and healthy.
River's short on the three. I mean, she just brings a certain type of energy all over the court, and I mean, she's chasing down rebounds. She's laying out into these sideline seats to save the loose balls. I mean, she just does all the little stuff for this team, and she's not looking for the credit, but she certainly deserves it.
She sure does. I mean, you love to have her on your team. You know, she's one of those kids that you can't stand to go against her in practice all the time, but you love having her on your squad because she just never stops.
And right there, she got her hand in there to force that turnover.
And then you got MJ. Between the two of them, energy-wise,
they're about the same.
Yeah.
Burnham got past Bonet, but short. Long lead pass up to Riggs. Got around Kaitu'u. And it'll be one and done for the Bearcats. It's Pilot basketball.
Well, you talk about MJ. Bruno, Spokane kid. You know, she was hurt later in that last year, second half of last year. And energy-wise, she, both of those two just bring a ton. But she expanded her game a little bit, three-point range. And just really doing a good job. And she has really kind of, I think, found her way into this system for Coach Meek.
Well, through that first quarter, Fowler played 8 minutes. She had 8 points, so effective in that short time. And a foul called. It's on MJ Bruno. That'll be her first, team second of this quarter.
I think she kind of just ran into her own player right there. Official didn't have a great view of it, but.
Well, Pilots get the turnover. It's Frawley fighting off the defender in the finish. That'll be her first points.
Great hands.
Pilots up by 14 with 8 minutes to go until halftime. Amai picked up her dribble. She's in trouble. Bruno with the aggressiveness right there.
I tell you, having those two on the front line in your press, that's not a bad combo.
Malika Samia makes her first appearance on the season, the freshman from New Zealand. Having a chance to talk with Coach Meek, he really likes what he sees out of Samia and what she has the possibility to do in a Pilot uniform.
Yeah, again, you know, transition as a freshman, but she's got a strong athletic body, can shoot it a little bit. Learning the system, plays really hard. I mean, he's recruiting the kind of kids that can play in this system, so he's really excited to see what she's. I like her frame. She's nice and strong.
Probably tried to go for the steal.
She almost had it.
Bonet with it, double teamed. Meeks in the face along with Frawley. MI gives it up to Esquenya Mercil. Floater on the run, off the glass, rebound Samia. Freshman taking it up herself. Meek to Kaitu'u, out to Samia, but it's partially blocked by the Bearcats. 15 on the shot clock. Pilots moving around the outside. Burnham fighting for position on the block. Can't get it. 4 on the shot clock. Meek gets past Riggs, and she gets fouled as she goes to the hoop by MI.
Good take right there. She didn't really have anybody to dish to. But, you know, shot clock winding down. Good job of just getting herself to the rim and making something happen, drawing the contact. Great job.
Yep. Meek last season shot 66% from the free throw line. Only had 6 attempts on the season.
Thought a little bit of an ankle injury, I think, last year is what it was, and just in and out, never could really get healthy. And again, that's such a factor for all squads, especially early in the season. You like to see, you certainly don't want to have people hurt, but.
Yeah, I want to say she got hurt in that one of the last practices before the season started last year.
And once game time, you know, once games start, it's hard to give yourself some rest.
Yeah, you're going to press yourself to get back into playing time and playing shape. Ho will come back into the game.
I mean, as a player, you want to get yourself back as soon as possible. You know, always push yourself to get back quickly and sometimes that kind of shoots yourself in the foot. Not quite ready.
No. Am I in the backcourt? Meek trying to cut her off. She gives it up to Ho. Bonet back to Ho near the elbow. Can't get Frawley off of her. Under 10 on the shot clock. Am I with it? Going up against Burnham. Lost the dribble. Puts it up over her. And it falls.
Good composure right there because she kind of lost the handle, like you said, and had herself kind of stuck in that key area. And again, they've had some decent half-court possessions.
That ended a 7-0 Portland run. Frawley inside. Off the mark. Riggs has an opening. Nobody in front of her. Meek chasing from behind. And it's all Riggs. That'll be her first points.
Yeah, Frawley just needs to go up strong to the rim. Kind of floated away from that one. Angle made it.
Squinya Mercil will be called for the foul. That'll be her first personal and the second on the Bearcats.
That's a tough assignment, trying to hold off Fowler underneath the basket.
I mean, what is it, three-time all-first team WCC selection, preseason selection for this upcoming season as well?
She's a really hard matchup for every opponent because she can play in and out. She's really athletic. You know, you put her at the four and she can run like a guard. And
I was going to say, it's sort of, she's got that 6'1 frame. And so you think, well, maybe I can get a size advantage on her, but her athleticism on the block really gives her that advantage.
That, and she's just so strong.
Yeah.
You know?
As Riggs and Burnham help each other up after the foul.
Good hustle by both.
But I think you bring up a great point with Fowler. Her ability to run up and down the court and lead the break half the time. I mean, it's what makes her so productive and get those quick baskets in transition.
Uh-oh, we got an injured player.
Riggs is down. She's holding her back on her side of the court. And she seems to be in a lot of pain.
Yeah, I don't know if she got hit on a block out, but it's almost like where a kidney would be.
Yeah. Head coach Peg Swadener, excuse me, Swadener was there to help Riggs on the court. So Danielle Morgan, senior from California, will come in now. And I think they're going to go over to the scores table, maybe give this a look.
Media.
And the last play is going to be under review, so we'll send it to break. 13-point lead for the Pilots over the Willamette Bearcats, 33-20, 5:41 left to go until halftime. Here's a look at Coach Meek. Bit of a different attire than what we're used to seeing. Normally a sweater vest guy on game day, but he's wearing the quarter zip tonight.
I like the look.
Kind of fits into the side of what all the coaches are doing nowadays.
Yep. COVID kind of changed the whole protocol for suit and ties. I think they're all happy about that.
Right. Well, Bob Huggins was the trailblazer right over at West Virginia at the time. He was the tracksuit guy.
Yeah.
Emmy Shearer called for the foul. That'll be her first personal, the third one on the Pilots in this quarter. Kai Tu'u will enter for Fowler. Fowler, no points in this quarter so far, but she did pick up those quick fouls.
I think that's going to be one of the things is, you know, as you watch the squad, being able to apply this type of pressure without getting yourself in foul trouble early or getting your opponent to the free throw line early in a quarter, that's going to be a huge key.
Pilot switch, one on the shot clock. River puts it up. It looked like it was partially blocked by Shearer, but the Pilots get it. Kai Tu'u in transition gets it to go with the left hand.
Great vision by Lindsay right there, pushing the tempo, seeing the forward running, and a great lead pass.
Bearcats dealing with the pressure from the Pilots, the quick passing. River, the floater, back iron. Ball still loose, and she gets her own rebound. Gardner. And the Bearcats miss back-to-back opportunities.
Yeah, they're playing hard, man. I mean, like I said, once they've attempted or broke the press with the pass, they're getting opportunities in the half court. Just completely rushed right there.
Yeah.
That's all that was.
Lindsay has it. Gives it up to Shearer at the elbow. Lindsay just inside the three-point line. Gets it to go.
She's really got a nice looking shot.
And a timeout call by Willamette as they're trailing by 18 with just over 4 minutes left to go. I think we'll keep it here with an 18-point lead right now for Portland over Willamette. Portland's on a 6-0 run. They've made their last three field goals. Willamette, on the other hand, they've missed their last four, but you just mentioned it, they were sort of rushed on those last two shots on their last possession.
Right, and it comes back to handling the full court pressure. Once they've attacked with the pass, they've gotten opportunities in the half court. It's just a matter of being composed.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get a great offensive board right there, and she just went up so fast, never really gathered herself to finish. So, you know, you look at the score right now, and it's all of a sudden gotten away real quick. But Willamette's done a nice job, especially in that first quarter, of just kind of hanging in a little bit. You know, right, you're going to run out of steam against a team that just keeps coming at you with a new five. With the depth that Portland has.
Yeah, the fresh legs constantly coming in. Oh, with the quick feet through the press and the pass to Collins off of her hands and out of bounds. And it's one of those cases of you want to be quick, but don't hurry. And that time they went too fast.
Yeah, and it's like you really didn't have a great opportunity right there. Just slow it down, pull it back out. It's like the tempo of this press makes you go faster than you want to. And that's what they're going to learn from this for sure. Little back door.
Shearer picks up her dribble. Kai Tu'u helps her out. Goes in against Collins. Out to Shearer. Back to Burnham underneath. And a travel call as she went baseline. Willamette has not scored in the last 2:28. And sent some hesitation out of you, Jen, as Shearer gets the steal on the inbound pass in the bucket.
So it doesn't feel like they haven't scored for that long.
No,
to be
it doesn't.
With you, so. Again, I like the fight that they have, and they're competing really hard, and they've had some opportunities.
Collins trying to save it from going out of bounds, and she throws it out of the sidelines.
And you can see everybody's kind of, you know, Megan's like, slow it down just a tiny bit. They're doing a good job of getting it to the half court. Just got to slow it down and get some execution in the half court.
Just under 3.5 minutes left to go until halftime. It's a 19-point lead for Portland. Oh, great pass to Frawley, but she can't finish it. Got her own rebound, gives it to Lindsay underneath. She'll take it out.
Really good pass.
Oh, beautiful feed to Shearer. The assist from Kai Tu'u. River trying to slow things down now in the half court. Has an opening, and it's blocked by Kai Tu'u, and foul called.
That whistle was a little bit late, but I really like what I see with River. I mean, she's trying to take leadership, you know, responsibility for the group, getting them in the half court. She's competing, playing hard. You know, you can tell she's got a scorer's mentality.
So Kai Tu'u picks up her first personal. Shearer and Burnham will go to the bench. Samia and Meek back on the floor. River with 3 points on 6 shots and her first free throw attempts. River last season was an 81% free throw shooter.
She had 14 points against Corbin the other night. And, you know, she's going to be somebody, I think, that's going to be a big factor for their success this season.
Lindsay, the open three, an opportunity, and it's off the mark.
Not a bad look, a little come behind for the point guard, and you can run that from a different bunch of different spots, but decent shot for sure, just a little bit off to the left.
I mean, that's kind of right where she likes to shoot it, too, so it's not often she'll be off the mark that much. River the pass, and broken up by Samia. Ball still loose, Frawley with it. Cross court to Meek. And now the Pilots swinging it around the outside. And great defense right there by Esquenya Mercil. Almost baited that pass into Kai Tu'u.
It was the right place to go with that. It just didn't have enough zip on it. She's got to get it up and over. Lead him to the backboard right there.
That's Portland's bread and butter, the blob plays.
Oh, my God. They catch him, you know, just a little, just not quite ready, and just boom, it's done. Ball's in.
It's an eye contact thing. You just look at one person on either side of the block, and they immediately know they're getting the ball. And it's a thing of beauty to watch sometimes. I mean, they're so well executed.
Yep. Frawley just a little too quick.
Yeah, she's 1 of 5 shooting so far today. And a 10-second call. The suffocation from the Pilots causing a turnover.
That's what I love about this kid. You know, she misses that layup. Gets it right back for him with her pressure defense, making things happen and getting that 10-second count.
Lindsay, the senior from Seattle, Washington, will inbound.
Coach Meek talked about just the type of kid she is. I mean, tremendous teammate. Selfless, will do anything, you know, for the group. The greater good of the group, I should say.
There's a three that falls for her.
And there's that little come behind.
She's got 8 points now. 2 of 3 from behind the arc. I mean, Portland right now, they've got 20 made baskets, 15 assists. They love to share that ball. Cross court pass to Meek. Long on the three. Offensive rebound by Kai Tu'u.
Liana's done a nice job offensively today. I like her composure. Done a nice job of just making a nice, smooth move from the block.
Extra pass to Frawley, rattles around, no good. Oh, rebound and the putback.
Great job of following your shot.
The extra effort again by Frawley proves it right there.
Yeah, you take a second off against that kid, and she's by you.
And that'll be the 5th foul on Portland, so an automatic 2 shots now for Willamette in the final minute until halftime.
Well, and if you're Coach Meek, you like this. I mean, a minute to go in the half or a minute to go in the quarter, they're in the bonus. But, you know, we've talked about their intensity and their aggressiveness in the full court press of sometimes getting quick fouls and done a nice job of playing that pressure defense without fouling.
Emma Straline checks into the game. As Emma Floyd missed the first free throw, makes the second. Now, she's a shooter for Willamette. We haven't seen her a whole bunch so far in this game, but given the opportunity, you don't want to leave her open.
Yeah, I mean, you can see just right there, nice form, confidence.
Samia, the three. Freshman can't get in on the scoring action. Pass deflected out of bounds into the bench of Portland. It'll stay with Willamette. Gardner with it. Going up against Frawley. Cut off by Kai Tu'u. The shot rattles off the rim by Floyd.
Good job by Mikkel here, just slowing it down. Play this last possession, time and score, real smart.
No field goals for Willamette in just under 6 minutes. Final 10 seconds until halftime. Meek against Gardner. Screen by Kai Tu'u, gives it up to her. The three on the wing, that's short. Rebound by Frawley, has half second and she can't put it up. That will end the half, but the Pilots have a 23-point lead, 46-23 over the Willamette Bearcats, and the defense was suffocating. No field goals in the final 6:08 of that half for Willamette.
Yeah, I mean, just tremendous effort defensively, and they've really got it going offensively, sharing the basketball.
We'll be back with stats and thoughts on the first half when we return on the WCC Network.
I love the fact that higher education can be transformative. It can change someone's trajectory of their life. And so it's my hope that the University of Portland, we are the transformative Catholic university in the West Coast. I was born and raised in the great state of New Jersey. I'm the youngest person in my family. I have some amazing parents who have sacrificed a lot to provide an education for me and my brother. You know, we grew up knowing you're gonna get your education, you're gonna go to church, and anything is possible as you go forward in your life. My name is Rob Kelly, and I am the president of the University of Portland.
We were simply thrilled when Dr. Kelly accepted the opportunity to come to the University of Portland. We spent hours, weeks, months discerning this important decision, and he was exactly what this university needs moving forward.
Hey guys, nice to see you.
I think you've already seen that on campus already. Dr. Kelly's everywhere. He's ubiquitous. He's energetic. I think he's a tremendous role model. His experience in higher education at this university and other universities will serve him so very well. There's no one more prepared to lead this university into its next great chapter here on the Bluff.
One. This is my first day with lots of students on campus in a physical format. The students are back, and this is the beginning of it. It's like Christmas morning.
Clearly a person that was able to build connections and relationships with people. His prior experiences, it was very intentional that Rob was preparing himself to one day hopefully have the opportunity to lead a Catholic university, and grateful that he chose us as much as we chose him.
I've been so blessed to know him for over 24 years, and one of the very first conversations we had, we found out we both loved higher ed, and he talked about, I want to be a college president one day, and it really struck me because my father was a college president, and so I saw a lot of similarities in somebody that I, you know, greatly admire and love more than anything. He is like the cheerleader for our family.
My children, Alex and Addison, first they ground me completely. They give all of this work that I'm doing and everything meaning.
To be such a collaborator, communicator, and somebody that really deeply believes in justice, it seemed like those were the things that he just naturally is.
I have been extremely blessed to have different people in my life. People like Sister Frances, she was my fourth grade school teacher. I remember those little lessons that she taught us, and I bring that with me into the work that I do now.
Welcome to all of you.
My message to students would be that they're loved. We want to walk with them and accompany them as they go off and do amazing things in the world. And we're always going to be there. It's about community, and we're going to help them to get connected as we go forward in life.
Welcome home, and go Pilots.
Dr. Kelly, on behalf of the entire Board of Regents, we are thrilled that you are finally here on the Bluff.
Dr. Kelly and his family, so grateful that you've become a part of the University of Portland. Can't wait to see all the fantastic things that we can accomplish.
Welcome, Dr. Kelly, to Villa Maria Hall.
Welcome, Dr. Kelly, to the University of Portland.
We're so proud of you and wish you the best of luck at the University of Portland.
Congrats, Dad, on becoming president. I'm really proud of you.
Every day, remember where your strength lies. God and heaven are below our feet and above our heads. And so always look up and remember that you are loved and you can do this. Congratulations.
Congratulations, President Kelly. God bless you.
Welcome back inside the Child Center on opening night of the 2022-23 basketball season. The Portland Pilots are leading the Willamette Bearcats 46-23. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. All right, Jen, it was pretty tight first quarter, you could say. I mean, it was well played by both teams. Portland broke away in that second quarter. What were your thoughts in that first half between these two?
Well, I agree. I thought that Willamette did a nice job of just kind of hanging in there. But there's the depth and the pressure that Portland's going to apply, you know, one wave after another, just kind of wore Willamette down a little bit. I really like the fact that they were allowed to pressure without getting themselves in foul trouble. There's so many people that contributed. I mean, they're 15 assists on 21 field goals. They got 34 points in the paint. So they're getting opportunities to score off easy buckets. And that's exactly what you want to be successful. And that's kind of the point of putting this kind of pressure and full court press on somebody. So I was really impressed, and I really like the new kids that have come in, and everybody really has contributed in one way or the other.
Yeah, and one of the big contributors in that first half was Maisie Burnham. I mean, she exploded for 11 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists, and that's just in the first half alone.
You know, she's just so versatile, like we've mentioned. You know, and there she goes posting up down low, and that's one of the things that she's really, really good at. She can shoot the 3. She can get to the rim. Super efficient. And again, you know, transferring in last year, I thought she did a nice job, especially late in that season, of really doing a good job of kind of knowing a role and getting herself going. But a great mid-range game, like one of the best mid-range. I love the mid-range game.
It's a lost art.
It really is. But she's got a turnaround jumper. She can get to the rim. She pulls up, you know, on a dime. And like I said, I mean, she's a versatile person or versatile guard that really can score in so many different ways. And she's going to be a big factor in how well these guys do down the stretch.
She might be that third head of the three-headed monster for Portland later on in this season. Let's take a look at some of those stats in the first half between these two teams. As you see, the scoring right now, 21 field goals for Portland, only 9 for Willamette. They've had some open opportunities. They've just rushed some of those shots, and they haven't gone down.
Yeah, I thought, you know, especially in that second quarter, I know they didn't score the basketball, but they did a better job of breaking the full court pressure and then just rushed in the half court. And that's one of the keys that that Peg talked about, is they've just got to be able to execute a little bit better. And you look at rebounds, 19-10. I mean, there's the size difference right there and just the opportunities. The turnovers is the big one, the 15-5. And it's Portland's got 16 points off the 15 turnovers, so that's a good ratio to go on.
Yeah, and the other thing, you talk about the size advantage, 34 points in the paint right now for Portland of their 46. It's because of Fowler, Burnham, Kai Tu'u, all of them rotating down there on the block and getting opportunities, and it's really just opened things up for them.
Yeah, and it really goes back to, again, all their pressure. I mean, their defensive pressure fuels their offense. There's not a ton of half-court offense being run, but when they do set something up in the half-court, they've done a nice job of posting guards up, high-low option, back and forth. I mean, movement's been good, on-ball situations, looking for people, you know, coming off the pick, little high-low, come-behinds for the three-point shot. So they've scored in a variety of ways, but their bread and butter is that press trying to create. I mean, they're shooting number 60%.
Yeah. Well, the players are back on the court warming up. We'll be right back in just a couple of minutes with the start of the second half here on the WCC Network. Third quarter just about to start here inside the Child Center. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. for the opening night of the college basketball season. Keeley Frawley inbounds to start the third quarter.
Well, really, I think the first 3 minutes of this second half for Willamette is really crucial. You know, I watched their body language, and these guys are playing hard, and they're bought in. You know, this isn't a game that people are going to expect them to win on the schedule, but a great opportunity to get better. And I like what I see with this squad. Leadership-wise, they've really done a nice job. But this few minutes here is really crucial against this press, I think.
You could almost say this is sort of a tone setter for your season going up against a caliber team like Portland and how they like to play fast against you. You know, set that tone for Willamette this season and know what the high bar is.
Great job of just coming off that curl. Riggs had an opportunity, just fell a little bit short.
And we're happy to see her back in the game, too, after suffering that back injury in the first half. Ho got past her defender, just missing.
Quality possession, though, offensively, I thought, for Willamette. Good opportunities to score, and like I said, competing really hard.
Squinya Mercil had the tough task of going up against Fowler. She'll pick up the foul. That'll be her first personal.
Yeah, she just can't get stuck behind. You get stuck behind Fowler, you're in big trouble. You can see her so deep in the paint,
yeah.
2 feet in the paint like that. You got to get three-quarter or fronter or something.
Fowler last season, 74.2% free throw shooter. She got to the line and shot 155 shots last season. Emmy Shearer checks in. Fowler will go to the bench. River in trouble, double team, just got her pass through the defenders. Now Riggs in trouble.
Good job by Riggs coming back to the ball for that. That could have been an easy turnover.
Esquenya Mercil takes advantage of the opening on the wing.
And that broken up play right there, nice job of finding the three-point line down at the other end, and a nice look.
That ends a nearly 8-minute drought from the first half of no field goals for Willamette. Pass inside to Burnham. Strong, ball still loose, taken in by Bonet.
Great lead pass by Frawley right there. Macy's got to do a nice job of knocking that one down.
River's pass off the mark, and smart by Burnham to not try to touch that one before it went out of bounds.
Yeah, I agree. She wanted to, though.
Yeah,
she was ready to go the other way.
Shearer gives it up to Kai Tu, who fighting her way through a couple of defenders and one.
That's a great little misdirection right there coming off, and then you're creating to get to the rim. The backside defense comes over to help. Somebody forgets to drop, and it's an easy look. Great job finding Liana down there, and just a great finish. I've been impressed with her this evening so far. I really like her ability to finish and just being strong underneath the rim.
58% free throw shooter last season. All iron. Ball is batted away as Riggs falls on top of Frawley. And yeah, Kai Tu just seems a bit more confident underneath the hoop right now than what we've seen in the past.
Just poised. She's more poised, I think. I don't know. I like it.
Burnham iron, and I think she went over the back. She'll pick up the foul.
Yeah, a little frustration foul right there. She's missed two easy little looks right there that she normally doesn't miss.
That's her first personal and the second on the Pilots in the quarter. Frawley saves it from going out of bounds and gives it up to Bonet. Bonet's pass goes out of bounds. And the referee fixes the original call and is now Portland basketball.
Lindsay had the call there. Again, that started with Frawley right there,
it
just
did.
Being so active with her hands.
Just a menace defensively. Lindsay going up against River. Got the screen from Kai Tu and denied by Esquenya Mercil.
Good defense right there.
Riggs with it, stops in front of Kai Tu.
Smart pull up right there. Unfortunate it didn't go down for her. Good hands by Ho.
Yeah, the former soccer player using her hands right there. And she'll pick up the foul. Too active on the hands. Both teams with three turnovers in the last 122. Looks like Bruno and Meek will come in. Lenzi and Burnham will hit the bench. And Mai comes in. Riggs and Bonet to the bench. Also coming in is Danielle Morgan for Willamette. Referees discussing near the paint right now.
I'm not really sure what they're looking at.
Yeah.
Maybe the game clock.
Game clock is reading 7:31 right now. Yeah, well, no explanation from the referee, so I'm not quite sure what just happened there.
I'm not sure either.
Yeah, nothing changed on the shot clock or the game clock. And that's the fifth foul on Willamette in the quarter, so now Portland should be shooting free throws. And it'll be Shearer.
Well, 7.5 basically to go in the quarter. That's a little too quick.
Yep.
Just trying to make things happen and getting a little too handsy.
MI picked up that foul. That's going to be her second personal and the fifth one on the Bearcats. Shearer was a 64% free throw shooter last season. She goes 0 for 2 from the charity stripe this time around.
Good offensive board by MJ Bruno.
Ryber just wrapping up Kaitu underneath.
She's laughing. She's like, I gave her a bear hug trying to get rid of it.
Kaitu will go to the line for the second time now. She's got 12 points. It's we were talking about Maisie Burnham at half with 11. Fowler had 10, and possibility to get up to 12, maybe 13 for Kaitu.
You know, the one thing that Portland needs to improve on, though, is they've gotten themselves opportunities at the line, and they're not capitalizing. You know, 50% from the free throw line right now. Much better shooting ball club than that. You know, not going to be a factor in tonight's game, but certainly.
You know, so once you get into conference play, those shots are going to matter.
Free throw line matters, absolutely.
Kaitu now shooting 66%, 2-3 from the line tonight. 52-26, Portland leads. And Bruno got caught with her hand in the cookie jar right there and called for a foul. That'll be her second.
I love how intense she is, but man, she just cannot hold it back sometimes. But just trying to, you know, get one from behind right there, and an easy call for the official.
River up against me, goes behind the back, gives it up to Ho. And that pass at the feet of Esquenya Mercil, and the Bearcats keep possession.
It was the right idea, just didn't execute it. Mm-hmm. Good hedge by Shearer.
Esquenya Mercil's already got 1-3 long, and a foul called. It's going to be called on number 22, Danielle Morgan.
Good job by Bruno of just making sure she's blocking out on the weak side board. Being strong, and she's going to find herself at the free throw line for that.
So four turnovers in the last 2-10, 2-12 for Willamette. Haven't scored in that same amount of time as Bruno goes to the free throw line. Made 5 of 7 last year, so 71.4%, missing her first free throw on the season.
Again, just opportunities missed at that free throw line, 50%.
Shearer gets caught up with Morgan for a jump ball, and that possession arrow will go for Willamette. River almost double teamed by Shearer and Lindsay. MI splitting the defense in the middle of the court.
Fortunate right there. Yeah. Just almost 10-second call.
Lindsay called for the foul. That'll be her first personal, the fourth one on the Pilots in this quarter. And so both teams, next foul by Portland will put Willamette on the line, and we still have 6.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
It's going to slow this quarter down the way these both teams are playing with the pressure. Quite a few free throw attempts, I think, are coming our way. They're going to go a little 1-3-1 here, half court. Good job by River of going over the top.
Yeah, fouled Morgan near the paint. That'll be Morgan's first points. Every Bearcat on the floor has points now. Shearer at the elbow. Finds Fowler underneath, 12 points now.
Great job by Alex of just staying strong, footwork, and getting position down low.
And the junior from Auckland, New Zealand, almost causing another turnover. I think my favorite part about this team is the ability for everybody to lay out, going for the loose balls. Nobody's too good for it.
No, they run this system, and they have bought into what Coach Meek is trying to do, and he recruits those type of kids that play right into his system and what he wants. And that's, I think, you know, that's the hardest thing is, again, going back, trying to prepare to play against them. You can't simulate it in practice. Mm-hmm. So even if you try to go up-tempo, maybe throw 6-7 players in it to make it a little bit more chaotic, it's like you get hit in the face right when the tip goes off. So it takes a little bit of adjustment for a lot of teams coming in.
Shearer called for that foul. That'll be her second personal, the fifth one on the Pilots. That puts River on the line for two. Already 2-for-2, make it 3-for-3 now. She's got 6 points. River, a junior from Tumwater, Washington, makes the second free throw.
Yeah, I've liked what I've seen from her. You know, she's doing a nice job not turning it back against the press anymore, and that's a key thing when you're getting pressured the whole time. You don't want to turn your back. Somebody's coming to take it.
Shearer went up with a rebound. Hit the deck. I will figure out whose foul it is. It's going to be on Morgan of Willamette. So Shearer will go to the line for two.
And there you see the athleticism of Shearer. You know, weak side board like that, just kind of getting off the ground and versatility and athleticism. He loves her length.
Shearer missing there. Let's get a look from one of the fans, noticing another missed free throw by the Pilots. There, Shearer makes the second one, going 50% from the line that time. 25-point lead now for Portland. Gardner crosses up Shearer, gets across the timeline, in the paint, gives it up to Collins. Am I with it? Morgan against Lindsay had the size advantage using the left-handed finish.
Great job. Just a nice little take to the rim and a nice finish with the left hand. Good possession by the Bearcats.
Fowler on the block. Goes in the paint around Collins with the right hand. No good. Collins with the rebound. 5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Ho is ready to come in for Willamette. Burnham and Samia for Portland on the next dead ball. Past the halfway point. Great pass from Morgan to find Collins, and the baseline jumper goes.
Both teams have done a nice job of drawing the defense over off the maybe a high post drive. Defense is a little bit late, and they've got that little slip pass and getting some easy looks.
Hand off to Meek. And Gardner left Meek alone.
Nice little step through there by Mikkel Meek.
Lindsay got a hand on it on the inbound, puts it out of bounds, so it'll stay with the Bearcats. And that'll send us to the media break. 4:09 left to go in the third quarter. Pilots are leading by 23, 57-34 on the WCC Network. Here's a look at the head coach, Mike Meek, in his fourth season at the helm for the Portland Pilots. His team is up by 23 points right now, and he's got his team humming. He's got three different players in double-digit points right now. Kelsey Lindsay has eight, but there's so many different players that can be a factor like that.
I think throughout the season, you're going to see stat sheets with, you know, maybe not somebody scoring 25, 20 every single night, but have the capability to do that, but maybe they have six people in double figures. And I'll tell you, as a coach, you would love to have that balanced scoring every night. I mean, it's so nice to be able to kind of go different. If somebody's not scoring the ball very well, you go to somebody else. And, you know, tonight he's getting a ton of rotations in, seeing people together.
Riggs with the take all the way. She
really
now has
really
4 points.
Nice take. They're not backing down, and you know right now it's 13-13 in this quarter. Stayed tough.
Yeah, well,
a lot of free throws.
Yeah, the Bearcats have made four of their last five field goals too. After at the end of the first half to start this third quarter, an 8-minute drought basically without a basket.
Nice little spin move by Fowler right there. Took one on the chin, but a nice move.
Emma Floyd checks back in. Collins will go to the bench for the Bearcats. Fowler 2-for-2 from the free throw line already with 14 points. Make it 15 now after that free throw. A bit quiet in the rebound category, only two so far. And she now has 16 points.
Yeah, the thing about her though, like whatever they need her to do, she does. And again, the versatility, whether it's scoring, defending, running the floor. You know, right now they're playing without Lucy Cochran tonight.
Yep.
They don't have Haley Andrews in.
Yep.
I mean, those are two big time players.
Basically, your quarterback on the floor is not there, then your best defender's not on the floor right now either. Lucy was what seemed like a scratch before today's game. We hadn't heard anything, but she's not come in and she's currently in sweats right now. As Fowler gets fouled, she'll head to the line again.
Yeah, not sure why she didn't play tonight, but you know, certainly don't want to have, if she's having any kind of issues whatsoever, not a game you want to test it out with.
Yeah, you don't want to come back too early and strain yourself even more depending on what the issue is. There's a look at her right now on the bench next to Haley Andrews. And Frawley, the effort to get the offensive rebound after the free throw, and she'll get rewarded with a chance to make a couple of her own.
Well, Portland has a big week this week. You know, Hawaii comes in on Wednesday, Stanford on Sunday, and certainly want to have her for both those games if possible.
Yeah, Hawaii's not a team to sleep on. They were picked to finish first in the Big West after winning the regular season and conference tournament last year.
NC2A tournament team and return a lot of people that are going to be pretty good.
And a big-time transfer, too, from Cal State Fullerton, the Big West Freshman of the Year last year, now on Hawaii's team. So a talented group coming in. Lane violation on Portland. Gardner finds Riggs.
I'll tell you, Willamette's done a really nice job this second half of handling the ball in the full court pressure.
Floyd to Riggs, going up against Frawley. Got some separation, picks up her dribble. Now it's the Gardner, the elbow jumper, no good, and ripped away by Maisie Burnham. She's looking up for an outlet. Finds Kai Tu'u just underneath the basket, and she finishes it high off the glass.
Good vision and a good catch, quite frankly. A little bit too far underneath the rim, and again, I really like her poise and the ability to finish under the rim.
Kai Tu'u now has 16 points to go along with 4 rebounds and 3 assists. Portland's on a 6-0 run as Frawley gets called for the foul. That's her third personal. So that sends Gardner to the line. MI checks back in for Riggs. Gardner, just a freshman, went to Bend High School here in Bend, Oregon. The Lava Bears. Kelsey Lindsay brings it across the timeline. Just over 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
I think they got a little snow there today.
I don't know if I'm ready for the snow right now. Burnham gets her own rebound. Tough take and the roll. Count it and one.
Coach Meek thought she got fouled on the first one, but a great job of following her own shot and then getting the second opportunity to score. And again, just so strong and versatile.
Floyd called for that foul. Burnham makes that free throw. She now has 14 points, 6 of 10 shooting, and 8 rebounds. So she's 2 rebounds away from a double-double.
Well, and something I think she's pretty capable of most nights out.
Floyd, the shooter, sinks it from the corner.
Nice job of drawing the same side defense and nice little kick to the corner.
Straylene, pass inside to Burnham, pass Floyd, and she gets fouled again. She'll head back to the line.
Well, the high-low has been there all night, and again, it could be a post player down there. A lot of times it's been the little bit bigger size guard. Here she is right here again, posting up. Got caught on the backside.
It's a great pass from Straylene, excuse me. Just right over the shoulder into that bucket for Burnham, giving her the opportunity to go up. She makes the free throw, and now she's got a team high 17 points. MI, elbow jumper, bit quick on that shot.
It's not a bad look. It's just, again, just going a little too fast.
Lindsay trying to create some separation against Gardner. Final minute of play here in the third quarter. Lindsay falling to the ground, kept her dribble. Now she's getting met with a couple of defenders. Straylene with it. 5 on the shot clock. She's going to drive, put it up as she stumbles, and it goes.
Great hands on the finish right there. I mean, I thought she was going to go head first there for a second, but good job of keeping her balance and a nice little finish.
And if I'm correct, that's Straylene's first points in a Pilot uniform. MI puts it up with 11 on the shot clock. Samia, the rebound. She could slow it down. 12 left on the game clock. Kai Tu'u steps out from behind the 3. Lindsay sees the clock running down, throws it up off the glass and no good. Well, these two teams are fighting it out here in the third quarter, but the Pilots have a 33-point lead. They lead 73-40. Emma Straline, her first points for the Pilots. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. 33-point lead for the Portland Pilots, 73-40 as we start the fourth quarter. MJ Bruno inbounds as we get things going. Bruno looking for the scoring column and can't get it in.
It's a good look coming off that. Just a little too quick.
A lot of fouls in that third quarter, slowed things down. Let's see if there's a difference of play here in the fourth. Ho beats Meek, and the pass goes off the thigh of Kai Tu'u.
Again, the right idea, just didn't execute it. And there's that high-low again.
Shearer backing into a defender, and a charge called. Bonet was on the receiving end of that one from Shearer. That's her third personal, team's first.
Good idea, just kind of lost her balance down low. They just have so many versatile long guards that can just post people up. We're going to see that all season long.
River.
Good pass.
Yeah, and she, misdirection right there, too, because she was staring down Danielle Morgan, and then she finds Collins on the opposite block.
Yeah, great job. She's done some really nice things. I know I've said it before, but I've been impressed with her so far tonight.
River with 7 points, 5 assists, and a rebound. Bruno gives it up to Frawley, now over to Meek. 10 on the shot clock for Portland. Kai Tu'u, the screen, gives it back to her. 5 on the shot clock, goes in the paint, and just off the lip of the rim, own rebound, left-handed put back.
Good drive with the left hand, just kind of faded a little bit, but great job of following her own shot and then finishing.
Kai Tu'u now has a team high 18 points, passing Fowler and Burnham, who both have 17. Frawley called for the foul, her third personal and the second team foul of this quarter. Morgan to River. Pass inside to Bonet, turnaround jumper at the free throw line, rattles home.
Nice little left-handed pass, bounce pass into the court. She got great court vision.
Yeah, they're starting to feel more comfortable, it seems like, in their offense. Now they're in the fourth quarter, seeing Portland for three quarters now. Bruno short on that shot. Meek takes it beyond the three-point line. 10 on the shot clock.
Well, completely overloaded on one side.
5 on the shot clock. Meek throws up one off the rim. Bruno can't corral it. River leads the break for the Bearcats. The transition bucket from the elbow doesn't go for Collins. Meek to Bruno. That three lips out.
That's a shot she's been working on.
Oh, the pass from River behind Ho. Squeña Mercil will check back in for the Bearcats. Collins to the bench. Foul on the Bearcats. It'll go on Ho. That'll be her third personal. The first one on the Bearcats in this quarter.
Yeah, they've been caught on that a few times. I don't know, just easy switch right there, make it a little bit simpler for them. Coming off that little rub screen.
Meek with it. The former 6A Oregon Player of the Year. Gives it up to the corner to Shearer. She puts up the three, it falls.
Good vision by Meek on that, drawing the defense, and nice over the top pass.
Morgan alone beating the defense.
I think that was Ho that threw that pass.
You would be correct. Ho now has 4 assists to go along with 6 points.
I think you're absolutely right. They're just way more comfortable than they were in the first half versus the pressure.
Kai Tu again finishing at the basket. She's got 20 points.
Good job by Willamette, you know, breaking the press and then a 3-on-2 situation. Portland picks up the quick foul.
Kai Tu's got a new career high. Her previous high was 16 that she set at Fresno State back in 2019 before she suffered that leg injury. She's having herself a game now with 20 points.
And really just nothing forced. I mean, just good quality possessions, good attempts, and super poised and strong around the rim.
Riggs with it, gives it up to Ho, top of the key. Over to Gardner, lost the handles to Bonet. 5 on the shot clock, Bonet partially blocked by Straylene. Meek inside to Straylene, turn around and she finishes it.
Great job of running the floor, number one, and then Meek finding her in transition, a little bit slower.
And talking with Coach Meek last week, he had high praise for Straylene and her ability to know where she needs to be on the court as Meek goes up, gets fouled by Ho. But she just has such a high IQ for a young player who didn't get a lot of playing time last year and finally is getting the opportunity, and right now she's making the most of it.
And that's what you got to do. I mean, you get an opportunity to play, you got to go and improve yourself, and obviously offseason is a time to get better, and spring and summer have been huge for all these players. And I mean, look at Liana tonight. I mean, you know, she did not have that poise, in my opinion, at this point last year whatsoever.
Meek makes the free throw. She now has 4 points on the night. Maddie Condren and Chance Bucher are set to check in at the next dead ball.
You get another post player down low that, you know, is an absolute threat when she touches the basketball, and it opens everything up for the outside perimeter players, and Liana's done a terrific job tonight.
Now she'll get a breather along with Shearer, with the 2 subs coming in for Portland. Under 5.5 left to go in the quarter. Jasmine Shigino checks in. Straylene trying to take the ball away, and foul's called on Riggs.
1 too many passes right there. She had an opportunity to score. She needs to take that up.
Riggs picks up her 4th personal foul. The 2nd team foul in this quarter. Portland's on a 6-0 run over the last 1:15. 3 of their last 3 field goals have gone down. Meek DeBruno steps inside, now to Condren. In the paint, gives it up to Chance Bucher. She's trapped underneath the hoop. And Esquenya Mercil poked it away. It'll stay with the Pilots. Ashley Collins will check in. And that will send us to the media break. Under 5 minutes to go until the end of this one. 84-46. The Pilots have a commanding lead over the Willamette Bearcats. We'll be back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with the call. Under 5 minutes left to go in this one between Willamette and the Portland Pilots. It's 84-46. And Jen, you know, we talked about it a couple times already here over the last third quarter and part of this fourth quarter, but Willamette really seems to be coming into their own here as of late.
Yeah, like you said, comfortable in the full court press. There's that little touch pass in the out of bounds.
See, there was no eye contact on that one, though. That was a no-look pass from Meek.
Yeah, I think, you know, coaching staff from Willamette's going to be pretty happy with what they've seen at points in this game, and they can learn from it. A lot of good ideas. Didn't execute some of the stuff, but I like their competitiveness. You know, they don't have a ton of size, so they're going to spread you out and really go. But I've liked the fight. And I agree. I think they've done a much better job in this second half of taking care of the ball.
Meek goes baseline, gives it up to Bucher. Around Collins, not enough on that shot. Willamette has not scored in the last 2.5 minutes.
Little half-court zone here by Portland.
Amai drives in, Bruno on defense. Esquenya Mercil picks up her dribble. Three on the shot clock. Gardner gives it up to Collins in the pass, just out of her reach. Samia and Shearer will come back in. Bruno and Meek head to the bench. Bruno just got into the scoring column too after that last basket. Portland on an 8-0 run over the last 2.5 minutes.
Well, we're going to get a chance to see some people that, you know, don't get a lot of run right now, but a great opportunity for them to get under the lights and get familiar and some confidence going.
Great move from Samia to get the defender to go by her.
Yeah, I think we're going to see a lot of this kid down the road. Great body control.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she seems to have a bright future ahead of her on the bluff. Shearer trying to close out. Amai steps by her and finishes at the hoop.
Good take. You know, weak side defense just a little bit late there.
Amai now with 4 points. Just over 3 minutes left to go in the game. Condren with it. Getting it inside to Samia. Gives it up to Shearer. Shearer steps in and how about a little hook shot over the defender?
Yeah, there's that length right there.
Shearer's got 10 points. So there's another double-digit performer for Portland. Collins, the elbow jumper goes.
Nice little free throw line jumper. She's got a high release.
Yeah. 8 points now for her. Condren double teamed, had it slapped away. Collins has it. High arcing three. Simi with this slows it down by taking it outside the three-point line. Sheer deep underneath the basket.
Nice little left-handed jump hook.
Poked away from Esquenya Mercil. It'll stay with the Bearcats. Emma Floyd checks in. Esquenya Mercil will go to the bench. Shearer goes to the bench with MJ Bruno back on the floor. 40-point lead right now for Portland. 2 minutes left to go in this one.
Little 1-3-1 here.
Amai to Collins. The three. That one goes. She's got 11.
And there's some range right there.
Yeah.
You got your center pulling out to the corner in the three-point line. You're in good shape. It's hard to guard.
Yeah, well, Emmett's got some nice things going for him. And a delay game on Portland. Inbound to Bucher. And Bucher's got her first points.
Good job again, out of the baseline, out of bounds. They literally haven't had to run anything. They've just caught somebody off guard every single time out.
Yeah, I don't think it's left the low blocks.
Nope.
Gardner, the open three. One minute. Final play, or final minute of play, I should say, in this one. Straylene comes down with a rebound.
Good look by Willamette.
Everybody scored now for Portland except for Maddie Condren. Bucher making that last basket. Condren trying to get some space underneath. The pass broken up by Collins.
Yeah, a little bit short on that pass. Condren, obviously, with the big size advantage inside.
Yeah. 15 on the shot clock for Willamette. 12-second difference between game clock and shot clock. 7 on the shot clock. Imai puts up the three around Condren, and it goes.
Well, I'm going to give Willamette a little bit of a pump here because they've competed the whole time, and they've got some nice pieces, and wish their squad the best of luck this season.
Yeah, it was a tall order coming in. I think everybody knew it, but they played tough, and they never gave up in any instance throughout this game.
Yeah, they've got some nice pieces, and, you know, in a conference that really doesn't have a ton of size, they're going to have some success, that's for sure.
So a 92-56 win for Portland over the Bearcats today. Here's a look at some of the final stats in this one. 37 made field goals, 25 assists for Portland. But the big thing for me, I'm looking at the rebounds and that disparity right now. That's going to lead to a lot of second chance points for Portland.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I think they did a good job on both ends of the floor rebounding and got themselves some easy opportunities, points in the paint we've talked about. And then that turnover, 24-11, you know, that's a nice job of taking care of the basketball on Portland's end.
Yeah. Pilots playing probably one of their better games in a while right now. It's nice to have the healthy bodies out on the floor to have that type of performance as they win by nearly 40 points. But the Bearcats giving an effort here in the fourth quarter. And it just falls away from them as the Pilots are greeting their fans here on the sideline. You love to see it. They get that support every single time, and they're always the first ones over there after the final horn.
Well, you love to see, you know, young people come into the game, and, you know, these are great role models for these kids to look up to, and getting a chance to meet your hero in a way, you know, is pretty cool when you're a young kid.
All right, I think we have Liana Kai too. Ooh, Liana, can you give us a thumbs up? Can you hear us at all?
Not yet.
Not yet, not quite, as well, we have Liana Kai too, but we're having some technical difficulties right now, so unfortunately we won't have her, but she would be our player of the game. She had 20 points to go along with 3 assists and 7 rebounds, and she just, what you said, I'm going to steal some of your words, she looked the most composed that we've ever seen her.
Yeah, very impressed. You know, I thought she was composed. I thought she did a great job of gathering and finishing. She didn't rush things. And defensively, she has always helped Portland with what they're doing. And again, if you have another post player that can score in and out, you're in great shape. And that's what she did tonight.
Well, that's Jennifer Mountain. I'm Brian Slyke. Thanks for tuning in for game one of our doubleheader inside the Child Center tonight on the opening night of the college basketball season. The Pilots take it 92-56 over Willamette.